this distinguished profession. Good morning. I just want to say a few things and then let you proceed with what brought you here to this beautiful county, Kwale. I'm delighted to join you this morning for the 17th annual convention of Kenya Institute of Plants. I'm bringing greetings and regards from President William Samoei Ruto, President of the Republic of Kenya. Kenya is rapidly developing. This convention, therefore, is an opportunity to canvass and align priorities for planners into the Kenya Kwanza Plan as we work in making Kenya a planning society. That is why the theme, integrating the blue, green, and brown agendas, mainstreaming planning in all sectors for attainment of national socio-economic transformation, is very timely. I note that the theme is centered on urbanization, on housing, land, natural resources and climate change, economy, trade, and investment. Esteemed planners, the Ruto administration recognizes a crucial role of spatial planning in socio-economic development. Further, we are committed to providing policy direction in land administration and management, urban development and management, as well as affordable housing. Thus, our target 250,000 housing units annually in 5 years. For sustainability, planners have to ensure the housing units are accompanied by proportional transport and infrastructure, as well as accessible social amenities. Through the Ministry of Lands and Physical Planning, we are working towards ensuring that land laws and regulations are regularly updated alongside mainstreaming spatial planning into development plans. This would fortify urban development and management. Esteemed planners, we recognize the importance of county governments in grassroots development. In this regard, we have supported counties in establishment and strengthening of urban institutions. As a result, the number of municipalities created in the last 5 years has increased to 59. There have also been substantial structural investments in the municipalities as a result of conditional grants from the national government provided for improving quality of life in urban areas. We are also advancing the National Urban Development Fund for sustainable financing of urban areas and cities across our country. Madam Governor, distinguished planners, in a bid to modernize and streamline processes, escalate the scale of the National Land Information and Management System. This expansion will facilitate integrated online application and planning and development at the counties. We are also spearheading digitization and archiving records, and we are fully dedicated to implementing as a platform. The success of these endeavors hinges on collaboration among government agencies, private sector stakeholders and communities. Esteemed planners, it is important therefore to address related challenges of environmental sustainability and climate change. For instance, this convention takes place when El Nino is causing havoc across the country. Buildings have been marooned and road networks destroyed. Lives and livelihoods have been lost and others are risk. This adds to the challenges of collapsing buildings across the country. Between the year 2009 and 2018, at least 87 buildings tumbled down, leaving 200 people dead and over 1,000 injured. The country lost over 2.4 billion Kenya shillings in such losses. Last year alone, 13 houses collapsed in the Nairobi metropolitan area. While such unfortunate instances have been linked to rogue contractors, substandard materials, limited or no geotechnical studies, greed among other factors, the ingredient of proper planning for a safe, secure, and sustainable built environment cannot be gainsaid. Distinguished planners, This conference, therefore, should delve into organization of climate financing in Uganda, building resilient urban communities, sustainable land and resource management of Uganda's. While the immense untapped potential in the blue economy, our administration will work with the Institute of Planners and other partners in addressing challenges in the sector and harnessing of maritime spatial planning for sustainability. In addition, the digital economy presents transformative opportunities for streamlining planning and management of data for informed decisions. On this note, I wish you a productive discussion and declare the 17th Annual Planners Convention officially open. But failing to plan is planning to fail. But we are there, we are good. And our administration is out of planning. And we used to say during the campaign trail, Kujipanga. Kujipanga is planning. Our whole governance structure as an administration is on planning. At any level, at the family level, at the hustlers level, at your level, at every level, planning is key, is critical. Planning is a key and critical component of our development as a country. All the things that have gone wrong in this country is lack of good planning. The situation we face today of a huge public debt is lack of good planning. Billions of Kenya shillings spent on legacy projects that had not been planned for the benefit of the country. The situation we are having in El Nino is because of lack of drainage systems in our cities. So this convention is being held at the right time. But planning is key. I've discussed with the chairman and the officials before we came here and we have agreed. And I'm going to have a meeting with the officials to come and take me through institutions of government where you think that at the board of directors we need a planner to sit in that board. And once they have persuaded me, and I'm a very simple person to persuade, one of them is that is moving in that's simple, so that I understand quickly. We'll make sure that planners sit in the boards of organizations where planning is key. That we shall do. Again, we have agreed that the counties are in charge of urban centers and towns and municipalities and cities. We have agreed that during the next meeting of IBEC, which I chair with the county governors, we invite the Institute to come and make a 30-minute presentation. Persuade them and convince them, first and foremost, the importance of planning, and secondly, and most significantly, to have professional planners working for them. Yes. And I think our governors are level-headed. I think they have seen reason. And at least the governor of Kwale here has said they don't have a choice. So I'm sure before you leave here, she'll tell you the source you need. need for planners in this country. So that you come and help her to govern. No, ourselves, we are not professionals in the life of planning. We are managers. But we need professional help to plan. So the importance of your institutes in this country cannot be overemphasized. So we are agreed and we are persuaded. And we don't need any further convincing that we need to embrace you to be our partners in national government. We want all cities, all urban centers to be properly planned. Let us not have hazard development that have no supporting infrastructure. It is you people to help us to do away with the traffic jam. It is you people to make sure that there are social amenities. Buildings don't just come up and there are no playgrounds for our children. There is no supportive sanitary and sewage system. So I want to say that this convention is very appropriate and we are happy to be here. And we seek a partnership in our area. As part of our strategy to plan and to make planning.
I want to